sit down. Good luck. There is something which you as Western can't understand, but I like to explain to you a theory how the things are. My God, the whale, huh? God bless the whale. This is the second Russian icon we got. Very, very original. All right. God bless Mary and Jesus both. And, when I talk to you, out of the entire gist of the talk, you only have the capacity to receive 6%. Do you know that? It looks very funny, but do you know that normally when two people talk, you get most of the essence of the talk through the cues rather than the words? Have you ever practiced that? An ordinary human being with a normal life only listens to 6%. Of the total conversation. Isn't it funny? So you take the certain important cues, certain things which either concerns you mentally, oh, I saw your girlfriend, where? You are not saying, I saw the girlfriend, I saw girlfriend, two words. Immediately your reaction is where? You are listening to the detail. Afterwards when they say, oh, she met me at such and such place, then your confirmation is on place, not I met so and so. Then you want to know, what you want to know and what the words are that you connect. You are not worried about all the conversation. You get messages like frog jump, here, there, 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 nowhere, anywhere. And this is normal. Fifty percent, you only pretend you are hearing, or you are listening. 50%. Are you aware of that? Your expression, real expression, what you want to say, is always 10% of the total communication you have sorted out to project out. And this is not abnormal, this is a normal, common, well-versed, educated human being. You use a lot of words like a preface. I want to talk to you. That's not enough. There are common phrases which you listen, which you don't care. If somebody wants to talk to you, you say, I want to talk to you. It is about a very important matter. It concerns you very deeply. Anything which you put out in threefold, it hits the target. Where Guru Nanak said repeat means go on repeating everything. There are some people I have met in my life, you have to tell the same thing 10 times. And still they will do what they want to do. Listening is very weak in human. That's why whatever little intuitive we are, we do not listen. Because whatever consciousness or our little soul tells us, that's too little, very feeble. We don't relate to it. Sometimes we do not understand, we want something. I want something, you want something. But we do not know what sequence we have to choose. We do not plan the sequence. We just want and project want and go for it. Sequence is not our way of life. And that's the biggest thing which causes a lot of discomfort, pain and disease to the human. Sequence is very important. Because sequence will guarantee consequences, not the result. Our life is based on results. I want to achieve this, I want to achieve it. That's wrong. You may achieve it, but you may not have it. Because the sequence may not certify the result, it will only certify the consequences. Like Trump started a divorce, a status to be bifurcated, litigation on his way. Lot of people will not like to put in money as they kindly could have been. A sequence got started, consequences are granted. Result may not be, he may not survive. Sequence and consequences are definite. Therefore, make the life as a resultant consequences than as a achieving end. How many of you have that tolerance? One percent. Tonight I would like to give you a simple situation. It is called self-hypnosis. I wish I should stay here more and continue the class. I'm not sure. Every time I say I'm going, I never end up going. So I have stopped saying that either. But I don't like to be in LA because the moment I come in here, I start coughing. I know. My body doesn't like it. I like LA, I'm not saying I'm wrong. But however, first time we are trying to get into self-hypnosis, you can learn it in 6-7 years in a university and may not completely do it. To put people under hypnotic trance is very essential. It's very curing, but not for anybody else, but for the person itself. Meditation does lead to that. A good meditator can totally switch his gears and put himself in a self-hypnotic trance to act in a certain way to deliver the goods. It's a requirement. It's not a gimmick. That's why you do not have strength, you do not have grit, you do not have projection to. It is not right for you. You don't understand. It's not right for you to move yourself. But also, at the same time, you move the entire environment. In older time, people used to say, yeah, he will be there. How you know? He'll be there. Because in their projection, they already locked that person. But now he will be there. We have to understand life like that. I don't know, actually, to be very honest. I'm willing to admit, I don't know how you live. I don't know, as many things you miss and kiss grass and all that, it's unbelievable. Because we don't develop our intuition to lock the totality. And if we cannot lock the totality, next is the reality, which is called God. While sometime, while learning that, there are ifs and buts, and we get very upset with it. But real life is very funny. Real life is no chance. It is, and it is. That's the truth about it. Let us today try to see how much fear we are in this. Please sit in any meditative easy pose or any hard pose you want to choose. Enjoy yourself. But please do one thing. Yesterday, some of you were moving like little leaves. Energy will be released, which is not yours. We release it at certain frequencies, but we expect you to keep your spine very straight. When you bend the spine lower-wise, you make it very difficult for yourself to enjoy what you're actually sitting for. If you can just sit in any way, but make the spine stretched up, which is not your normal way of sitting. Right? Close your eyes. And now breathe through the mouth like a pipe breath, they call it. Like drink full length. Drink full breath, one stroke, full breath, and then exhale. You always breathe, you never drink air. Make the breath longer, deeper, and fuller. Try it. If you drink a full breath, it will be a very, very big breath. You have never enjoyed that way. Drink in a full breath till you cannot take any air in, and then let it go. That's all you have to do. If you do it right, it works like a pendulum, as they put before your eyes and they use their optical nerve. You're using your own rhythm of diaphragm by conscious breathing. Drink fuller and deeper. Sit straight and right, concentrate. Your arc line shows majority of you are reaching that status. Some of you are not interested, that's fine with me. That is your personal loss, I have nothing to worry about that. But please try we have actually a group of achievers. If you are yawning, you are lucky. Openly yawn is part of the process. Now make an effort to make the breath longer and deeper and effective. Try, concentrate. Breathe deep. Breathe in one breath, full chest and deep. You are unable to break your own tension, what you can do for anybody else? Come on, let's get going. Now inhale deep, breathe normally, close your eyes, all is. Meditate on zero. Shunya, zero. I am zero, all is zero. In the beginning was zero, now is zero, zero shall be. I am zero, all is zero. Zero was, zero is, and zero shall be. My thoughts are zero. My disease is zero. My problems are zero. Multiply by zero comes everything zero. Zero was, zero is, and zero shall be. I am zero, all is zero. Please do the self-hypnosis, hypnotize yourself over zero. Now everything you think is wrong with you, multiply it with a zero and make it zero. Your fears, one by one, multiply them with zero and they will become zero. Simple mathematics. What you like and want, please don't multiply that. I am zero, my problems are zero, my fears are zero, my negatives are zero, threats are zero. Now expand yourself and may all negativity within and without surrounding and projection, all negativity multiplied with zero. Your sorrows, multiply them with zero. Control the physical make all negative unwanted things, thoughts and projection zero by multiplying it with zero. Now take your choices thought, most positive thing you need the most, and lock on it. Repeat it with mental continuous thought, beam on it and lock on it. Lock it. It has to be one word. You need wealth, you need health, you need anything. Just one word, lock it and repeat it. Repeat it, lock it. Send the constant beam. Your one personal thought, lock on it. Hold it, don't let it slip by you. Tell me what you want. Lock it, it will be yours. Lock it.
Krishna.
Don't move the physical. Inhale deep, hold the breath, move your neck round and round. Holding the breath, move your neck please. Don't get into trouble. Move it round. Exhale fast. Inhale again. Hold the breath and move the neck. Move the shoulders. Exhale. Inhale again, deep hold, keep on moving, move the entire physical spine and the body, hold the breath and relax. Okay, you're fine. Take your hands up, please. And stretch your spine to the maximum you can do. All fingers like steel, hard, open, wide open, no touching. Breathe deep and stay there up. Stretch, 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 become a little taller. This you have to do by time schedule, I can't help you. Come on, come on. One more minute, you will be fine. Up, 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 up. Keep the pressure upward. Seconds more. Keep it the same level of pressure. Fifteen more seconds. You are doing wonderful. I really appreciate. Come on. Come on. Inhale deep and hold tight. Inhale a little more. Hold tight. Little more. Hold tight. Relax. Ooh, oh. You are fine. Play big music and have fun. Rejoice. May the long time sun shine upon you, all love surround, and the pure light within you guard your way on. And Satnam, don't move though. Don't move. Stay where you are and try to relax, okay? Play some music which they can play. I go to myself trying to. Play some good one.
Oh.
I'll see you. I have a meal.